What's up? What's good, Sato? It's the sensei.
Bow to your sensei. Bow to your sensei! Okay.
Back again for another reaction and review. So lately, I've been on a huge BabyTron wave. You know, I feel like I was sleeping on him for a good little while. Recently, he came to my attention as a good contender for a young star in the rap world. You know, he's got some serious punchlines. I think it's something that the rap world needs to know about. I feel like everybody's sleeping on him too, honestly. But he just got put on the freshman XXL list, so hopefully more people will start getting hip to his music from that. But I'm also trying to do my part in getting more and more people hip to BabyTron. So today we're going to react to his new music video that he put out called Talkin' Flagrant. He always has some beautiful sports references, and I feel like he's definitely going to have one here, you know, about maybe DeMarcus Cousins or Draymond Green. You know, somebody in basketball who would be getting flagrant fouls and stuff. We'll see if he does. We'll see if it's one of the players I listed. I'm just trying to make educated guesses here, but I'm definitely excited for this track and excited for his new music in general. So let's go ahead and get right into this reaction. Talkin' Flagrant by BabyTron.
Damn, Spark, you shot this?
Damn, where the fuck is Simba? Coach put me in the game, I'm number one contender.
Sauce, you better figure out. Y'all little stupid ass.
If you lost in the sauce, you better figure out. Pull up on a bitch, I'm in her walls, but I ain't in her house. She ain't sucking dick, David Beckham, I'ma kick her out. She ain't sucking dick, why she here then? Why? If it ain't the one above shit, I don't fear.
I mean, he's already going crazy. He said, I'm in her walls, but I ain't in her house. And then he said, if she ain't sucking dick, David Beckham, I'ma kick her out. So obviously, David Beckham is like a very, very popular professional soccer player. If y'all don't know, BabyTron is from Detroit, so he kind of falls under that rap style of really just talking shit over a song, flexing, and a lot of it's freestyled. Sometimes they write, but they really go for their punchlines, and they're not always on beat, but they still make it sound good regardless.
Sipping wok with gang, you drinking beer with your weird friends. Said that I ain't talking, well, you must ain't got no ears then. Boy, is you deaf? Think you ballin', but you playing both sides. Boy, is you ref? Shooter came through hitting everything like, damn, boy, is you Steph? Remember looking in that mirror like, shit, boy, is you next? I'm just playing up. Been knew I had it from the jump, I'm just saying up. This little bitch, she need an Oscar, how she playing rugs? Turnpiking with my driver, make her pay the tubs. I can't put you on this one shit, but I'm making up. Cuddy got some lines of yellow like he finna paint the rug. Was you born in Gotham City, you be... Man, you be saving her. I cannot really relate. I be saving pros. You ain't.
He said, was you born in Gotham City? Man, you be saving hoes. Essentially making a little reference to Batman, obviously. Just too funny to me. I guess he's saying he doesn't have time to, you know, save any of them. That's not his personality. Dude, look at his chains. Whatever that... Can't tell if it's like a bear or a gorilla or a dog right there in the middle, but that one's kind of hard. Then he's got his Shitty Boys chain, so that's his rap group, Shitty Boys. And then they also call themselves Dog Shit Militia. It took me a while to be like, bro, why is he saying this? But now I kind of think it's hilarious. And I watched an interview where he was talking about the name, and apparently, like, him saying Shitty Boys at the time, the people he was around using the word shitty didn't at all mean what a lot of us conventionally would think of the word to mean.
Part of the militia, then you ain't my bro. You ain't trying to bop it while I'm with you, then you ain't my life. Bitch, put your head down. Trying to go to sleep, she trying to go a 10th round. Used to be the man, heard he fucking with the help now. Shopping with a 60 on me, damn near tore the shelf down. Back in high school, the hoes did my test for me.
Where?
If you let me get the new Nike tech for me. What's your bank? If you let me drop this check for me. Since you let me put your loyalty to test for me. Tour time, I've been everywhere. I ain't skip a flight to the top, I took every stair. If he play with us there, he get buried there. On the other side of...
He said, tour time, I've been everywhere. I ain't take a flight to the top, I did every stair. So he's saying, he grinded. He's not an industry plant like... He worked and worked and worked to be able to get up to the top and finally be relevant in the rap game. And I think I missed a lot of his climb, but since going back and listening to some of his older music, he has been doing it for a little while. Not that long. I think like he started in like 2016 or 2017. So what's that, like 6 years? I mean, that's a lot of dedication. But also some people, I mean, it takes them even longer. So good for him to be able to do it as young as he was.
Greenfield, this ain't Gary Ware. This that hutch work. Punching in the booth, but I go back to that punch work. Where I'm from, when they get like that, better up first. Shit, or you can say your last word. Doing one what? I don't know. Watch the cat burn. I know your ass tire working 9 to 9. $4,000 pint with a bitch who's fine as wine. I don't really give a fuck. Guess what? The time is mine. Lil Brody on the move, won't say it that.
He said $4,000 pint with a bitch who's fine as wine. So, you know, kind of a play on different things that people like to drink. He's saying he likes the lean, but he's hanging out with a girl who is fine as wine, you know, because, like, fine wine is a delicacy as well. So he's with the baddie drinking on a pint. His chains are really glistening in this video. He, you can tell he spent some good money on them, but also I like how he's been flexing his Crocs, because he's, like, very open about, like, how he is always in Crocs, and I gotta respect it. You don't see that often from, like, real famous people, so why not?
And you like a mind. Protect BabyTron at all costs. Shit, that's what the fans say. Hanging off a cliff one-handed wouldn't fall off. Shit, boy, I'm man-man. I don't owe nobody. I done did some shit that I ain't told nobody. Walking past my old hoes, don't know nobody. Why you got a stick, ain't finna blow nobody. Why you got a stick, you ain't finna, yeah. 3 of red, 2 10s, feeling dead. Should be getting active, you a chillin' stead. When I step with my brothers, we ain't finna build a bed. I am not Will Ferrell. Why you toting BB guns, I'm not real barrel. In the dirty game, my hands not real sterile. You was the good kid. It's been up and stuck since the day I found the good Ben.
Hey, shitty boys. Back in 2016. You know, back then, type shit. I'm a vet.
Hey, he said 2016. Shitty Boys back in 2016. I was right, or I was close at least. I really enjoyed that song. I'm excited to go listen to it in the car and see how I feel about it then, because that's when I really be bumping BabyTron. It's just like jamming out in the car, you know. Trying to get somewhere fast. It's going to make you want to drive a little bit faster. So, yeah, nice for that. But I love his flexing. I think he does a great job with it. He's got very creative punchlines. I know I wasn't able to pick all of them out there. I'm sure there was quite a few that I missed. The ones that I caught, I did enjoy a lot. He also said something about, I am not Will Ferrell, and so I got quiet at the end because I was trying to sit here and think, like, what does he mean he's not Will Ferrell? But then he said something about, like, other people using BB guns. So I think essentially what he was saying is, like, he's not the funny man, you know, he's not one to play with, and Will Ferrell is a comedian and a comedy actor, so I guess that was probably what the reference was. But I really enjoyed this track. If I were to rate it from 0 to 10, I wouldn't say it's like his best work, but I did like it a lot. And with BabyTron, I feel like you really gotta hear it in the car. For the time being, I'm gonna give this one an 8, maybe an 8.5 out of 10. I liked it, I think it bumped. I don't think it's on streaming platforms yet, though, just on YouTube at the moment. So we'll be waiting on that one, but let me know what you all thought of the track down in the comments below. Let me know what you thought of the video as well. And if you enjoyed my reaction to this one, please go ahead and drop a like on the video. And if you haven't already, please make sure to subscribe to my channel. Thank you all for tuning in. I hope you all have a sensational day.
Sensational.
And I'm out. Peace.